Hi, I'm Mike, and on this installment of Summit Racing Quick Flicks, we're going to discuss exhaust pipe sizing. When building a custom exhaust system out of miscellaneous components, it's important to understand how the industry sizes different components that are going to be necessary to build that system. Exhaust piping, mufflers, collector reducers, all are going to be sized differently from one another to assure compatibility and to make sure they made up with one another. What we're going to discuss is the difference between the measurement of these items when it comes to OD in comparison to ID, and what components are going to go ahead and fit together with one another as an end result. The first component we're going to discuss in building one of these systems is the exhaust piping. Most exhaust piping is going to be measured using OD dimensions. It means the outer dimension of the pipe or the outer diameter. That means that if you were to purchase a 3-inch pipe, let's say like the one we have here, the outside diameter of this pipe would actually be 3 inches. This is, creates a situation to where this pipe is then designed to be used as a slip fit or slip into a component that has a 3-inch inner diameter then. And that will essentially create what's known as a lap joint between those two components, where one fits within the other component. This is important to understand because sometimes you have to connect one pipe to another, say from a collector reducer over to the pipe itself. Well, this creates a situation now where the two items cannot actually be slipped within one another, and it makes it not possible to have that lap joint like we just mentioned. This is what's known as a butt joint instead. Exhaust system components such as mufflers and exhaust tips normally use inner diameter dimensions on the piping used to build these components. Most of the time this does create a lap joint fit when it comes to connecting the pipes to these components in the system. The most common type connection when connecting a piece of exhaust piping to a component such as a muffler is what's commonly known as a lap joint connection, which essentially means that we're going to be able to insert the pipe into the component, as shown here. This type connection is probably the easiest to deal with as well, because you can typically take a standard saddle clamp or the proper band clamp and get these two connected to one another, or you can just weld the seam between the two as well for a leakless fit, essentially. These will always have some measurable leakage though if using a clamp to connect the two, because what will happen is you'll always have that seam between the two components that's going to give it the ability to have just a small amount of leakage between the two. The other type of connection used in a system is what's known as a butt joint, meaning that both components are going to have the same outer dimensions as one another. Exhaust piping is a common area where you're going to encounter this. This means that when you go ahead and try to connect the two pieces, you'll notice that it gives you a seamless fit, but at the same time you're going to have trouble getting the two components connected with one another without the proper clamp or being able to weld the two components together. This can prove to be difficult for the do-it-yourselfer that doesn't own a welder, is at home in their own garage trying to build a system independently of buying a pre-formed system specific to their vehicle. Here at Summit Racing, we carry a couple different clamp designs that are going to be used depending on the type of joint you're trying to connect together. The first two we're going to focus on are lap joint connection clamps. First being the saddle clamp, which we're probably most used to seeing. This clamp here is just going to use a U-shaped bolt essentially and a saddle bottom, which is going to basically crimp the two pieces of pipe together to create the seal. We do have another option though, which is what's known as a band clamp. And a lap joint band clamp is going to be evident because you're going to notice that one side is going to be visibly larger than the other. It's literally going to taper, meaning that you have one pipe that's going to be fitting on the inside of another. These do not clamp as much as they hold the two pipes stationary and create a full 100% seal via this seam internally here. These being more desirable of the two clamp designs because you don't get any distortion of the pipe when they're connected together. In comparison, when connecting a butt joint connection, your only option in the clamp world is going to be to use a band clamp. Reason being is that a saddle clamp will not have enough, there's not enough meat to connect the two in a saddle with a saddle clamp design. If you look at the difference between the two band clamps out there, you'll notice that the lap joint has the tapered end on it, whereas the band clamp used to connect the butt joint is going to be the same diameter throughout. There's no tapered edge, it's the same internal diameter. This is a good solid way to connect the butt joint, but the best way to connect the butt joint is via welding. There is a way also to go ahead and convert your butt joint over to a lap band joint. We sell this tool here at Summit Racing Equipment. This is a tubing expander that basically is just going to go ahead and create the extra clearance internally inside the tube to make it so that whatever component you're trying to connect will now slip into the component that you're expanding. This is a good option if you want to go ahead and use the saddle clamps as an end result to build your system. For more quick flicks, visit the Summit Racing YouTube channel. Visit Summit Racing online at www.summitracing.com. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/summitracing, or like Summit Racing on Facebook at facebook.com/summitracingequipment.